WLNY-TV, New York 55.
Good evening, and welcome to New York 55's Late Show, Cat Chaser, starring Kelly McGillis.
WLNY-TV, New York 55!
The Stone Cold Surprise turned out to be good for mankind,
and their
but
partners,
bad for Shawn Michaels.
Kevin Quinn and Too Sexy, Brian Christopher.
We have a brand new WWF champion in mankind. You know, you just can't say that sentence without a smile on your face. 15 years of toiling labor, a man who has given so much of his body is now WWF champion.
And if there was ever someone who really deserved to be champion, who really deserved to be WWF champion, it's a man like Mankind, because as you said, he has worked hard, and this is his life.
So it's eight-man tag team action to kick off the hour. Plus, folks, we will see Gangrel in action a little later on, plus the Acolytes in tag team action against the LOD. Brian Christopher not endearing himself to the fans about ringside, but that's nothing new.
No, someone who did endear themselves to fans last Monday night on Raw, Stone Cold Steve Austin. And my gosh, did you see the reaction from the fans when Stone Cold came to the ring and made it possible for Mankind to be WWF champion?
We'll show you that later on, folks, as Bob Holly and Jeff Hardy are starting off this eight-man tag. Leapfrog by Jeff, great agility. But Bob snatches him now, going for a vertical suplex.
You know, last Monday night, Kevin, at first, I didn't even think that Mankind was gonna be in the Royal Rumble itself, much less the new champ.
Boy, it certainly appeared as if Mr. McMahon has always held all the cards, manipulating after Mankind had asked for a WWF Championship match against The Rock at the Royal Rumble. Mr. McMahon said, no. Not only that, you're going to have to qualify to even get in the tournament and take on Triple H. Oh, but Shane will be the referee. You kind of expected the outcome that came out of that one.
And Shane screwed Mankind. A fast count on Triple H. Triple H, of course, got into the Royal Rumble, but then it was Mankind who got the last laugh, almost snapping Shane's shoulder, forcing Mr. McMahon to give Mankind a title match, not just a title match last Monday night, a no disqualification title match.
Yeah, The Rock was not really prepared for that one, and Mankind realized his dream, becoming the WWF champion. The Blue Meanie is in now, folks. Last week we saw a little dance contest with Brian Christopher, and here we go, the neck breaker now on Matt Hardy. Two count and Christopher in to make the save. Take a look, Bill. The Hardy boys started off quickly on the Meanie. Nice elevation there from Jeff. And the tag is made, Bruce, and Kevin Quinn is in. Of course, Kevin Quinn has been the most recent tag team partner of Brian Christopher.
Well, of course, because Scott Taylor with that injured knee has been resigned to the outside of the ring. And Scott Taylor not even making his way down to ringside this week.
That'll be a little disheartening for that young man. Scorpio's now in off the tag. And that was a nice clothesline there. Scorpio and Bob Holly teaming with Dwayne Gill and the Blue Meanie, the unified members of the Job Squad. The only one missing, of course, is their leader, Al Snow. But you know, after that hardcore championship match and the bloodbath, Al Snow is probably never going to be the same.
Al Snow versus Road Dogg last Monday on Raw, one of the greatest matches I have ever witnessed, Kevin. And Al Snow didn't win the hardcore championship, but put in one of the greatest fights I've ever seen.
Who would have imagined that a championship that began as a joke gift to Mankind for Mr. McMahon, has now become one of the most prestigious titles to be defended in the WWF. The light heavyweight champion Dwayne Gill is in the ring. Off the dropkick, the cover, and the two count only.
You know, Kevin, we're going to take an in-depth look this Sunday at the evolution of the hardcore title on Superstars. Of course, that's 10 a.m., 9 central on the USA Network.
And now Kevin Quinn. Oh, nice bulldog. Great counter. This Kevin Quinn is an impressive young athlete. In fact, all eight men in this ring, very impressive. Kevin Quinn now looking to tag his new partner, Brian Christopher. Christopher now going to the second rope. Can they continue to assert their offensive advantage on Scorpio? Drop kick in the back of the head. There's some dancing for Brian Christopher.
Again with the dancing.
Well, there's not going to be any dancing in the Lion's Den match. That's right, a Lion's Den match. An 8-foot steel pit. Inside will be Owen Hart, one-on-one against Steve Blackman. And that match will take place this Sunday night, live on Heat, from the sold-out Freeman Coliseum in San Antonio, Texas. Lion's Den match this Sunday, live on Heat, 7-6 Central on USA.
And there is no escape from the Lion's Den. Of course, Kevin, it's also going to be unfortunate that we're going to be in San Antonio, Texas, and that our commissioner, Shawn Michaels, probably will not be in any condition to appear.
And that's because of the dismemberment that Shawn Michaels received at the hands of the corporation last week on Raw. Dwayne Gill driven face first to the mat by Brian Christopher.
You know, I almost didn't recognize that it was actually Shawn laying atop that car. He was so beaten.
Certainly was. He has suffered multiple injuries, folks. He is in a local San Antonio medical facility. His condition has been upgraded to guarded, but how long will it take the Heartbreak Kid to recover? And what of the commissioner's spot? I mean, who will fill the role in his absence?
You know, the question I wonder is, was DX a part of it? Did DX set Shawn Michaels up for that attack?
Well, we are going to relive what exactly happened to Shawn Michaels in just a little while, folks. And we'll let you be the judge. Was he set up by DX? Oh, man, what a maneuver there. Tremendous powerbomb off the elevation from Matt Hardy. And now Jeff is going up top.
The coup de grace.
And now look at this incredible elevation. Leg drop, crossbody combo, hook of the leg. Oh boy, the Meanie had to make the save. Folks, this one continues. Eight-man action, stay with us.
All their lives, they've been threatened
to disobey me, and I will bury you.
And pressured to obey.
This is your opportunity.
I don't want your life.
On January 15th. It's time to change the rules.
She's taking the car!
You don't always have to do the right thing. You must better than football.
Varsity Blues.
You are under arrest. Pick up your clothes and get in the car.
Rated R. Starts Friday, January 15th in theaters everywhere.
Croft, for your latest assignment, you'll be going to some new places. South Pacific, Antarctica, and you'll be getting some new toys, Gunther.
This is a new rocket launcher, a girl's best friend.
We've been watching you. Your work is very impressive.
Tomb Raider 3, from IDOS Interactive.
Oh, and one other thing.
New outfits.
PlayStation.
Eat the Whopper.
That's 40 grams of fat.
Go ahead. Get the everyday Whopper value meal.
61 grams of fat.
Burger!
Naughty.
Listen to your smarter half. Go to Subway, where you can get one of 7 subs with 6 grams of fat or less.
Enter the Get Fit giveaway now at participating Subways. You could win awesome fitness equipment or a trip or two to the luxury health spa La Sport in St. Lucia.
Subway, the way a sandwich should be.
Because there just aren't enough days in the week, we bring you The Weekend. Introducing DeVry's Weekend College for Working Adults. Now, you can get a degree in computer information systems on the weekend. Our accelerated schedule of courses lets you work on your degree while you're working. DeVry's Weekend College. It's convenient, it's practical, and it's only on the weekend. To learn more, call 1-800-423-7000. DeVry, for a higher degree of success.
Welcome back to Shotgun. Eight-man tag team action continues. Scorpio now on a rampage, letting everybody have it.
Scorpio's doing all right by himself right now against all four members of the other team.
Now, wait a minute now. The Meanie's in. Bob Holly's in as well. This Matt Jack Doan is quickly losing control of this contest. Watch out. Elevation on the far side.
Well, Shawn Michaels was sure in control for a little while last Monday night. Of course, naming Mr. McMahon, giving Mr. McMahon his wish in the Royal Rumble, and naming McMahon the number two participant in the Royal Rumble.
That's right. Sunday, January 24th, folks, of the 1999 Royal Rumble, Stone Cold Steve Austin is the number one entry in the 30-man over-the-top rope Royal Rumble. And Mr. McMahon will be in the ring second. He is number two. And Triple H is also qualified thanks to his victory over Mankind. Incredible elevation from Scorpio. Wait a minute, Christopher in to make the save.
And I wouldn't put it past Triple H to be someone who would want to go after that $100,000 bounty on Stone Cold's head.
Well, I'm telling you, that is quite an enticement. Mr. McMahon with 100 grand atop the Rattlesnake's head. Oh, wait a minute now. Kevin Quinn trying to hold Scorpio. And, well, he sort of dislodged Brian from the top, much to Brian's chagrin. Still men battling on the outside. I'm assuming that Scorpio and Christopher are the legal men. Look at this, Bruce.
We've got action all around us.
Version of the victory roll leads to victory for the Job Squad.
Here are your winners, the Job Squad.
Job Squad victorious here. Well, because, of course, the Job Squad, more of a cohesive unit.
And now it looks like Brian and Kevin are having some issues. Whoa, wait a minute now. Another party to be heard from.
Well, I didn't even think that Scott Taylor was here this week because he wasn't at ringside with Christopher and Quinn.
Had to really burn his bacon to see his partner victimized like that, falling off the top rope. Wait a minute now. Why, it's starting to get heated, Bruce. Kevin Quinn having to defend himself to Brian Christopher, and he does so with a drop kick to the back of the head.
I think Quinn's had just about enough of
Christopher's
mouth.
Wait a minute. Oh! In from behind is Scott Taylor.
And Taylor cracked that crutch.
Oh, what a nice moment.
Too much reunited.
Oh! And again.
Look at the way that crutch bent.
What a hallmark moment, I guess you could say, for Scott Taylor and Brian Christopher.
Yeah, a very touching moment.
Well, folks, there is a lot more ground to cover here in the hour. But right now, we're going to take a trip to Slam Jam. Here's Doc Hendricks.
Stop!